One of the common modifications we'll make to a car when we're modifying it for race use is to remove some of the compliance out of the factory suspension bushes. This compliance, which in stock trim is there to remove some of the noise, vibration and harshness that could be normally transferred from the wheel and suspension assembly into the chassis, also means that the wheel alignment becomes less consistent, particularly under braking and cornering forces. This also makes it more difficult for the driver to accurately position the car on the racetrack, and the driver loses a little bit of accuracy in terms of feel of the car. Now, while there are harder bushing materials such as Nolathane to replace the factory rubber bushes, these still allow some level of compliance. For ultimate performance in a race application, it's common to replace a factory rubber bush with a rod end instead. These rod ends, which are also often referred to as Heim joints or rose joints, essentially are a spherical bearing that removes any compliance at all while still allowing the suspension components to move and allows a certain degree of angular misalignment. Even when we consider rod ends, there are a range available here, and it really depends on our application and the required strength as to the correct option for your particular application. In particular, they start with low carbon steel, which provides a low strength and also a low cost, through to aluminium bodied rod ends, which step up in terms of strength and also reducing weight, and then ultimately we can move into chrome moly rod ends, which provide a significant improvement in strength. For a race or road application, most often we're going to be using a Teflon liner inside of that rod end. The Teflon liner means that we don't need to grease the rod end because it is self-lubricating. This is particularly important when these rod ends are used in a dirty environment, because a greased rod end will attract that dust and will then result in quick wear to the rod end, providing additional play and requiring that rod end to be replaced. Well, the upside of using a rod end is that they offer absolutely no compliance, allowing a lot more accuracy with positioning the car on the racetrack. The downside is that they will transfer noise, vibration and harshness into the car, meaning they're not ideal for road car use. And even if you are using a rod end with a Teflon liner, these will still wear much quicker than a conventional rubber bushing, meaning that they will require replacement more frequently.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.